Hello, everyone. Welcome to Verbling. Verbling.com, where you can connect and practice with a native speaker instantly. The native speaker for this hour will be me. My name is Jeff Watson, and I am from Vancouver, Canada. But right now, I am living in South America. I'm living in Santiago, Chile. So, in my classes, I encourage all of the participants to practice speaking as much as possible. And the topic for this hour that people are going to be talking about is about social assistance programs from the government, or social benefits. All right, and so let's get started. I'd like to make sure that everybody gets as much time to practice as possible. Gabriel, are you there?
Hello.
Yes, hello. Please introduce yourself, and can you start our conversation about social assistance, social programs?
Okay. My name is Gabriel, and I'm from Colombia. Well, I'm not sure that social assistance is when government pays some benefits to people that maybe have disabilities that are unemployment, or maybe to mothers have too many children and don't have how to feed them or things like
right.
that.
Families that need financial assistance?
Yes, and also for people who don't have money to pay for the doctor.
Oh, excellent. Oh, very well done. You've described everything. Yeah, thank you very much. I'm just going to ask everybody to please mute their microphones right now so that we have a quiet classroom. And so, what do you think of the situation in Colombia?
Well, in Colombia, we have about medical service and about support to others who have many children. But at the same time, we don't have social assistance for people who don't have a job. And I think it's really bad because we are one of the countries with most unemployed in all South America. And I think that's
the highest rates of unemployment.
How do you say that?
Yeah, I'll put it in the chat box for you. The highest rates of unemployment. Yeah.
The highest rates of unemployment. Yes.
Okay. I'm going to move on, but thank you so much for starting the conversation. Fantastic job. Julissa, how are you?
Hi. Fine, thanks. And you?
Excellent. Thank you for asking. Please join our conversation about social programs.
Yes. Well, in Peru, the government destinates 1% of the public investment in social assistance programs, but this is focused mostly in rural areas. I think it's rural.
Yes, rural
yes.
areas.
Rural mm-hmm. areas where there are poverty or extreme poverty. So it's basically and some of these social programs are designated for nutrition programs, education. Also, some of them give some money to these families that can cover their expenses, their basic expenses. Yes.
Okay.
I think it is an important part of the social politic in our country.
Okay, and you said that 1% is spent on that?
No, a quantity. I think it is 43% of the public. Public expenses.
No, well, congratulations to Peru. I think that's great. in my opinion. Laura, hello. Laura, are you there? Okay, I'm going to go on to Rodrigo. Are you there, Rodrigo? I've muted your microphone.
Yes.
Excellent. Please join our conversation.
We have analyzed the data. Okay. In Peru, for example, the government has created social programs to people who don't have enough opportunities to immerse in their education. So they,
yes.
So
hi, Jeff, once again.
So
no, sorry, go ahead, Rodrigo.
So they have free education, and the government cover the how to say la alimentación, cubre la alimentación también de ellos.
Yeah, this is food, helping people to buy food.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. No, excellent, great, great. Sofico, hello.
Oh, hello. I have no idea what do you mean, and I can understand what do you mean under the social assistance. Please explain if you can.
Yeah, so these are things like paying benefits to people who are disabled or people who have lost their job, families that need financial help, senior citizens after they have retired, all of those types of things.
And the governmental help and governmental institutions that make this help or what?
Yeah, all of these programs we're talking about are from the government.
Okay. We have rather non-governmental institutions that make such things, but government has not such programs. I mean that not many programs. Of course, there is some programs, and it's mostly connected to money assistance. I mean, they are providing with money people, poor people, and about disabled people. It's very bad system in Georgia, and I think only families, disabled people family can really help them and in rehabilitation and make things happen in their life. But governmental system is not working well in Georgia, I mean for disabled people.
Yeah, okay, no, thank you. Those are really good issues. Hello, Vanessa, please join our conversation.
Hello, everyone. Well, I would like to say that here in Spain we have, I think, a good social assistance for people, but, well, now, you know, with the crisis, it became less, and, well, a lot of companies have aids to hire people.
Sorry, a lot of companies
have health
health programs. Health benefits.
Yes.
Have
programs for the government to hire people that they are in groups that are difficult to join to the laboral.
No, the government is trying to encourage companies to hire people.
Yes, that is people who have some problems to get into the laboral work. For example, for old people or for women, some things like that.
Okay, so in programs to help different groups of people find work and enter the workforce.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, great. Clemson, hello, please join our conversation.
Hello, in my country, I don't know if this is a social assistance, but scholarships from university, federal universities, they give scholarships for students who don't have enough money to live. There are a lot of different scholarships, for example, for lunch, for dinner, scholarships for bus, for take the bus, and for pay a rent, for live, these kind of things.
Okay. And then who is this assistance for? So first of all, students can receive this kind of assistance?
Not all students can receive. I, for example, don't receive these scholarships. Only people who can prove that they need the money for complete his studies.
And so people have to win those scholarships, right?
Yes.
With good marks?
Yes, I don't understand, sorry. What?
The students need to compete for these scholarships. They need to get good marks.
Yes, they need to prove, and even if one person needed the money and there is no enough for these people, they don't receive. So there is an amount of scholarships for people.
Okay, excellent. Gabriel, please continue our conversation.
Well, here in my country, talking about education, we got the assistance of the government in basic education because it's free. There are completely schools.
Sorry, just quickly, could you try and increase your volume?
Okay, there are completing free schools for basic students, but it's not really good for college because public universities are really expensive despite they are public, and it's also really difficult for poor people to get into a public university. So I think it shouldn't be like that, because they should have more opportunities to study in a university, and government is not guaranteeing that.
Yeah, so poor people, you're saying it's almost impossible for a poor person to go to a public university?
Yes, it's really hard to get in a public university.
Okay. No, excellent point. Thank you. That's something that a lot of the people are talking about here in Chile. Julissa, go ahead, please.
Yes. Well, talking about the economy, in our country, it is said that our economy is growing, it's going better, but there is a need to, not only to, how to say, there is a need to have more social inclusion. I think this is the idea behind all these social programs. They want to try to distribute the wealth of the country, especially to those who have less social inclusion. But some people disagree with this kind of social programs because they think that with this we are only maybe trying to solve things at the moment, or only maybe spending money giving, helping people, but maybe not helping them to grow their abilities to make their own.
Yeah, to be independent.
Yes, that's the word. So it's like as they say that this could be like assistentialism. I don't know if that's the word, assistentialism.
Well, no, let me see. I'll let me work on that a little bit.
Yes.
It's so a little different.
Some people disagree with these kind of programs because of that. And I had a chance to be in a very small community where one of these programs is being applied. And the people every month receive, I think, 200 soles. That is the currency here, 200 soles. But I think these families don't spend the money that their government give them in what it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
For health.
Sorry, I'm going to move on, but thank you very much for putting that. I mean, how does the government ensure that the money that they're giving people is well spent?
Yes.
Rodrigo, go ahead with a comment, please. Rodrigo, are you there? Okay. Sofico, go ahead, please.
Yes. I recall it now that there is some programs for unemployed people, and it provided by governmental institutions, but the quality of this program are not good. They are providing teaching computer programs, foreign languages, but no one wants to hire such people. Mm-hmm. It's just it has not any results. So I think they are just wasting their time and money and nothing more. It does not help unemployed person.
Yeah, okay. So those programs sound really good.
It sounds really good, but it is not working in real life, you know, because no one wants to hire such persons. They have the system in our country is built in a way that everyone finds job by connections. Everyone wants to have only acquaintances, so no one will hire the stranger from somewhere, and so it does not work.
They only hire the people who they know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Great. Vanessa, go ahead, please.
Yeah. Well, I would like to say to Gabriel that here in Spain there are public universities and colleges, and people receive financial grants to study.
Yeah, financial grants or scholarships.
Yes, but it is true that I don't know how to explain. Often people get money through these ways, but they don't really need, how Julissa said. Because, for example, their parents are working but without a contract.
Okay.
Yes, and they say that they have less money than really they have. So this is not good for all of us because we are paying that with our taxes. I a little bit disagree with that.
No, and that's another important issue, is who should government benefits go to? Should they go to everyone or just to poor people?
For example, here in Spain, we used to have a subvention.
Okay, I think that's a subsidy.
A subsidy for people who have child. For all the people who have child, you have received about 2,000 euros, but it doesn't matter if you have work or not, or you are multimillionaire or not.
You're a multimillionaire.
This is crazy. Multimillionaire.
Yeah.
That is crazy, I think.
Yeah, okay. No, excellent. Clebson, go ahead with another comment, please.
Yes, I was thinking here about the Brazilian government. I think that is a little unfair because, for example, a people who is retired receive one salary, for example, 622. And people who is under arrest for robbery, for example, their family has saved 900 in 50.
Okay, could you just repeat that again? I'm sorry, I didn't understand. Something that's unfair. Mm-hmm.
The government Brazilian is unfair because people who is rented, I don't know if this is the right word. Rented,
people
who work a lot of time and then stop it because they're old.
Okay.
Yes. They receive 620 Brazilian reais.
Now they earn, they make,
they earn,
they receive.
They receive the 622. And people who okay. is under arrest
Sorry.
Has
Just,
saved
I'll,
900...
I'll go ahead, Gabriel. I'll go back to...
Okay.
Well, I want to talk about...
Go ahead.
...to pay for having cute girls in my country. Hello? Can you hear me? Oh, he gets across me.
What happened?
He is frozen.
Yes, he said that his internet connection is not good, so.
Oh, well, maybe I should continue?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Well, we have a problem here with the subsidy for having children.
Sorry, Gabriel, where are you from?
From Colombia.
There is not much control also to see if they are really using the money in the correct way. It's also a problem.
Yes.
Welcome back, Jeff.
I'm glad all of you can keep talking. So who's, whose turn is it? Gabriel?
Yes.
Yeah, please, go ahead. Sorry for the interruption.
I finish.
okay. And so, Gennaro, how are you?
I am fine. And you?
Please join our conversation.
Okay. I am from Italy, so hello to everyone. In Italy, we have some social benefit, social program, but now we are in a situation more difficult than some years ago. So the benefits now are reduced. It were better, for example, 10 years ago. In Italy, if you lose your job, you can receive for a short amount of time, I think 6 months, a part of your salary. For example, I think the half or 2/3 of the salary, but there is a maximum too. So a typical help for this kind of people can be 1,000 euro for 6 months. And then
right.
During this period, you have to look for another job.
You have to find another job.
Yes, yeah. You have to find another job.
Sorry, I'm going to move on, but that's great. I was really curious about some specific examples. That sounds like what we have in Canada. Julissa, go ahead, please.
Yes. Well, like I was saying before, I think we need to have a better, a good control of how these families are making use of the money, because they are supposed to take their children to health controls, medical controls, or check-ins, and yeah, also to take them to school. Yes. So we need to control more of this, doing regular evaluations about this. Then a new program that we have in, that I think it's very good, is called Pension 65. This program has the purpose to help our elderly people, people who maybe they don't have a pension, they don't receive a retirement money, because maybe they didn't study at all.
Sorry, they don't have a private pension, or right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So the government covers this.
Yeah.
But only in families where there is a need, extremely poverty or poverty.
Yeah.
I think in this case, yes, it is important to have this amount of money to give them, because our elderly people, they don't have the strength to work anymore. So they need this to cover their needs.
Wonderful. Great. Ramsey, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Yes, hello. Could you please introduce yourself and join our conversation? We're talking about social benefits.
Okay, my name is Ramzi. I come from Turkey. I live in Istanbul, and I'm a vet. Economical problems is most important topic in the world, all around the world, not just Turkey. All European countries, also America, United States, or other countries. I think I had some visits the other countries during the last year. I saw some happened about people. I think every country's situations different from each other. For example,
I'm going to move on, giving each person 1 minute. And okay. I think everybody has very different situations. Rodrigo, go ahead, please.
Okay. In Peru. The government figured out a benefit to all people that they could receive every year amount of soles to survive. That benefit called Pension 69.
Okay.
69.
Mm-hmm. So it's and why 69 is the age of the person to receive the benefit?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. And do you support this?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
Because I think they need to receive a support from the government, because at that age people are not able to support themselves.
Okay.
They need to receive
support. Financial assistance. Yeah.
Yes. Great. Financial assistance.
Sofiko, are you there? It doesn't look like it. Vanessa, go ahead, please.
Well, due to the crisis, Genaro said here in Spain, there are a lot of cuts about this type of subsidies?
Yeah, these kinds of benefits.
These kinds of benefits, yes. And mm-hmm. we must we must be the same as the rest of Europe, you know. And I mean, they are cutting subsidies and grants or raising taxes, but we have so the standard of living much higher due to the higher prices, and the salaries are frozen.
Yeah, salary, yeah.
And we have to pay more and to have less. The citizens are a little bit angry with the situation.
Angry.
Angry, sorry.
No, that's good. Yeah. Oh, just the trick with the pronunciation. Yeah, so people are angry about that. They're mad about that. Okay.
Yes,
yeah.
Because, for example, in public health, we are having a bigger, a big cut about the things that you can have about public health. And in Madrid, for example, they are starting to privatize the health.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's been a hard year.
Yeah, those are really difficult changes. I can't imagine that happening in Canada. It would be really difficult. Clebson, go ahead with a comment, please.
Yes.
You need to. Yeah, there you go.
Okay. I was hearing the question here about the benefits for people who was victim of a crime. I think that there is no benefit here in Brazil, but the instead, people who make a crime and is under arrest, their family received a money for this. Yes, there are also, for example, benefits for kids. For example, if they their parents die, if they don't have age enough, they receive an amount of money until they complete the 18 years.
Okay. So orphans are taken care of by the government?
Yes, yes.
Okay. And that's what you were talking about. So people working for the minimum wage earn $600. But
yes, yes.
And the family of a convicted person receives 900.
Yes, receive 900 in 15.
Wow.
Because this is why I guess that is unfair. In the family who is the victim, don't receive nothing.
They don't receive anything.
Yeah.
Wow. Difficult. Yes. Gabriel, go ahead, please.
Well, I would like to say that something positive about social benefits in my country is that they have a good cover. They really are covering all the people who need it, and that way it's a good system. And
there's good coverage.
Yes, there is a really good coverage. Yes, sometimes it's a slow system, but at the same time, I think that they are good because they can coverage all the people who need it.
Yeah, okay. So the benefits are getting to the people who need it.
Yes.
Excellent. Gennaro.
Okay. About the situation of the retirement, job retirement in Italy, as Vanessa said, there is a crisis, so it was raised the age in Italy in which a person can receive, we call it pensions, but I don't know the English word.
The retirement age was raised.
The retirement wage.
Sorry, age.
Age.
Was raised.
But how do you call the amount of money that you receive when you are retired and you have the benefit?
Yeah, sorry, this is the old age pension.
Old age pension. Yes, it was raised in about 4 years in a moment in order to face off the crisis, and this get angry a lot of Italians that think that they were going to reach the age, and they see the threshold rise, and so away from them.
No, that's a very difficult situation. Julissa, go ahead, please.
Yes. Well, sometimes these kind of programs have they are working very in a very separated way, and sometimes they are covering the same specific needs. So I think it would be also helpful if we could have these programs could be combined or make a combined work, not to be so spread.
Sorry, are you there?
Connect. Yeah. Yes, because sometimes they are working towards the same purpose. So one family maybe is part of two programs that have the same objective. So it would be helpful if they could be mixed, so the money could be used in a better way.
Yeah, it could be managed more effectively. Often we say there is a duplication of services.
Yes,
so you have paying for two government organizations to do the same thing. It's very inefficient. Sorry, Ramzi, go ahead.
Yes, I would like to add something about this topic. In the past, before in Turkey, retirement age was very early. Many young people were retirement in early age, as 40 years old, 42 years old. But then, government saw it's a big problem, this, because the government didn't pay money to go on the system, and then we changed our retirement age now for ladies 60 years and for men 65 years old. And before I would be a chance, but now I haven't got any chance for early retirement.
Yeah. No, great. Thank you for sharing that with us. Rodrigo, are you there?
Yes.
Yeah, please go ahead.
I think retirement as Rainsil told, I think is...
Yes, sorry.
In people, when finish working, they need to receive help for the government, because they were paying part of their salary. Mm-hmm. So they have to receive a benefit in the end.
Yeah, they should. They should receive a benefit because they had been paying taxes their whole career.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Excellent. Great. Sofiko, a comment?
Yeah. Okay, I wanted to speak about disasters, natural disasters. And Georgia has many refugees. They are making financial assistance to such kind of persons who were forced to leave their living places and move to another places. They are trying to provide with houses, but unfortunately, it's not. I mean, that it's not for everyone. They cannot afford. I mean, the government cannot afford to help everyone. They are just choosing the most poor, most damaged persons and in need persons, and they are just helping them. And Georgia's country also receives many subsidiaries from other countries, from Europe, from United States of America, from other countries. And when it has very bad times in 1993, when wars happened in Georgia and began in Georgia, they received a lot of help from outside. And they are still receiving help from Europe and other countries.
Yeah, so we often say international aid.
Yeah.
And they're trying to give help to the neediest people. That's a term that we use quite a bit. Vanessa, go ahead, please.
Yeah, did you ask if you feel that spending taxes in this way is correct? Of course, I think that is. Sorry?
I think he's frozen.
Sorry, okay. Vanessa, your signal is a little broken.
No, it's yours,
maybe.
I think.
Is that me?
Yes.
That's me.
Okay.
Sorry, please go ahead.
Yes. Well, about the question.
I think that I muted the teacher. Sorry.
Okay, about the question, do you feel that spending taxes in this way is correct? I think that, of course, it is necessary to help people because we have to be unit and help each other. Because there are people who really need it, but I have to say that many people take advantage of this type of subsidies and to get it way they shouldn't have, and we should control more this, and instead of give money, for example, try to give to help people to get a job or some things like that.
Yeah, so people are taking advantage. Now, subsidies, government subsidies, is something a little different. So benefits, I think, is probably benefits. The best word to use.
Okay, benefits.
Can you hear me? Yeah, okay, sorry. Yeah, government benefits. Yeah, wonderful, thank you. I just think that all of these benefits should be very carefully managed. So, yeah. Clebson, go ahead with another comment.
Yes, about a woman who is pregnant, the government don't pay for a woman who is pregnant here in Brazil, but the company who this woman works is that one who pay for 6 months after they burn the shield.
Sorry, the last phrase that you said?
Is the company who pay for a period for 6 months after the child has born.
Ah, okay. After the child is born. Okay.
Yes.
No, good. So 6 months of maternity leave.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But that's not paid by the government.
Not the government who paid this.
Yeah. Wow, okay. And Gabriel, are you next? Great.
Yes, okay. Well, I think that in general form, all these kind of benefits to be focused on to help people to have more opportunities to grow up, because sometimes these are just help and people have bad habits because they don't want, for example, if I have a government who pay me, what would I work? Sometimes people cause this bad thinking. And I think that government should assure that people have the opportunity to find a new job. Or maybe maybe to grow out. And if they are have disability, they have to have the government to guarantee that they have the opportunity to be treated as everyone else. That's what I think.
No, I personally, I totally agree with you.
Okay.
Sorry, I have a very poor connection. Please continue to the next person, Gennaro.
Okay. Also, in Italy, there is, in some way, a debate between different generations about social benefits, because, as we said, now with this economical crisis, better social benefits are required, but now there are less money than 10 years ago. And so in some way, there is the same problem. Who is the generation, which is the right generation to give to these social benefits? So the older people or the young ones? The young ones find more difficult to find a job, because now is more difficult than after the Second World War, you know. And this is a little bit sad, because it's a fight between, in some way, fathers and sons and so on.
I'm going to move on, but thank you for that comment. It's like dividing families to see who will receive the benefits. Julissa, go ahead, please.
Yes. Well, I agree with what Gabriel said. Sometimes this program should not only be paternalism and just give money and money. Because what would happen if the government stops giving money to the people? Maybe they will feel like they don't know what to do. So it's also important to create capacities in these people to make their own income. But just as a starting point, it's good, the help of these programs, because some people don't know how to cover their basic needs. But then I think it to make this process sustainable in time, you need to promote the increase of capacities in people.
Yes. Right. Wonderful. Yeah, that's great. Sorry, I forget the next person, Rodrigo. Go ahead, please. Sorry, Rodrigo.
Yes, I think it's a good idea to create a system program to help people, not only giving money. Instead, they could invest in education and capacity. Capacity to the people don't have opportunities to get a job. If the government could capacity them in a technique to work, and they could support themselves, and they don't need to receive support from the government.
Now, fantastic. I really agree with your comments. We have a new person here. Sorry, I can't see your name. Please introduce yourself. Snoozy?
Rusty Lab.
Can you hear me?
Hello.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. The new person, go ahead, please.
Okay. Snoozy? Hello. Hello. My name is Rastislav, and I am from Slovakia.
Yes, please, go ahead.
It is a small country in Central Europe.
Join our conversation. We're talking about government programs and social benefits.
Okay. So, in our country, we have programs to support people that are poor, but these programs are often misused by some groups of people. For example, many students, our universities are free, but and you can also gain a social scholarship if you are poor or something like that. And there are gaps in these laws because many people who are not even poor can gain this money because you can just change your address.
Okay.
And it should be different from address of your parents, and then you can gain money for that.
Okay. No, thank you. I'm going to move on to the next person. So people are cheating. They're lying and cheating to get the benefits.
Yeah. Yes.
And Snosi, are you there?
Yes. Yeah, hello.
Yes, please, go ahead.
My name is Bubeker. The last name is Snosi.
Oh, okay, Bubeker.
I'm from...
Please introduce yourself.
Yeah, I'm from Tunisia, North Africa. You're talking about benefit. What
yes,
side of
government benefits.
Yeah, what... Oh, or which side you're talking into regarding...
Well, sorry, just any kind of comment about the situation in your country.
Well, I think there is a benefit, but for the student, as for assurance, like accident assurance.
Yeah. Okay.
Am I pronouncing it right? Assurance.
Accident insurance.
Insurance. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and that's helps if they doing in these special ways as good as they are right now.
Okay, good, thank you. And we are using the Google Hangout chat box. I don't see Sofiko there, so Vanessa, do you want to go ahead, please?
Yes, of course. Well, I would like to answer a question that you make about... I can find the question. Well, does your community have things like free health clinics, libraries, recreation or centers, and cultural centers? And I would like to say that I think that we should promote more the culture and education system. But it seems that the government only want people that they don't know anything. They don't. It's like they don't want that we are intelligent. Do you understand me?
Yes, they yeah, but really?
I think so. The culture is for rich people. For example, here in my country, it's like that. If you want to go, for example, to the theater or something like that, you have to pay a lot of money to go there. And it's been more difficult to get a degree because the taxes are increasing a lot this year. And I don't understand very well why. Because, for example, the politician people, they earn a lot of money. I don't understand very well why they can earn so much money, and they need that we pay more.
Yeah. Okay. Great. Let's go back to Sofiko.
Okay.
I want to speak about pensions in my country. The government trying each year increase pensions for all the persons, but there is not good correlation between pension and the essential the prices of essential needs. I mean that the basic mm-hmm. things you need to live. There is very they are the prices on things that you use every year. They are increasing as well, and there is no relative attitude. I mean that good correlation between them. So it's still pensions are staying low. I mean not enough to provide with normal life. Provide normal life for people.
No, wonderful. Thank you. I put some comments in the box. Webson, go ahead, please.
Yes, I think that the government here in Brazil should change some rules because, for example, they spend a lot of money with football, and sometimes I think that they let the education in the other hand. I think that the most important thing in a country is the education. So this needs change here because they give much more value to the sports like football.
Yeah, and so your country is spending a fortune on the World Cup and the Olympics. How do you feel about that?
I think this is unfair because in this year we spent almost 7 months in strike in my university, and they spend a lot of money with the football. I think that didn't be this way. I think that education is much more important than football.
Right. No. Great. Thank you. And I guess these are final comments, Gabriel.
Okay, well, I agree with Vanessa. Government should incentivize the culture. Right now, for instance, in our city, we're having a international classical music festival, and government is offering free tickets to all the city. So I think that is a good benefit to incentivize culture.
To promote. It is more common, right? No? And can you think of another example where they're promoting culture?
Well, only that, because they don't use to make that, and I think that is a good start.
So so they have not been doing that. All right, great, thank you, awesome. And sorry, I'm really frozen here. The next person, the gentleman from, sorry, I don't remember your name. Gennaro.
Okay. In our county, there's the same situation some people said. So, for example, theater tickets are quite expensive. That's strange. But you can find small theater with a semi-professional company of actors, and so the price goes down. And I think that benefits about culture are very important in order to promote the culture of the citizens, and is not right to cut off this kind of benefit. For example, to theatrical companies. Mm-hmm.
So you support continuing funding for the arts?
Yes, it's important to avoid misuse of this benefit, but is not.
Sorry,
right.
I'm going to move on to Julissa. Thank you so much, Julissa. Okay. Go ahead, please.
Yes, I agree that sometimes that we need that the money should be invested in cultural projects or recreational centers, libraries. But I think the main purpose of these social programs, at least in the developing countries, the main objective is to reduce the poverty right now, I think. That's the main priority.
No, wonderful, Julissa. Ratislav, a final yes. comment from you, please.
Okay, so in our country, very little money goes to culture and sport, which has results in, which reflects on the results, and for example, the championships and so on. So, very little money goes to sports and to culture, which is pity.
Mm, okay. No, thank you. Sofiko, a final comment, please.
What can I say? That I think that in social system there is more easy to live for everyone, and in capitalism it's very hard to live happily for everyone.
Okay. No, good. I'm a big supporter of socialism as well. And Vanessa, a final comment to you, please.
Yes, in the reference that the last comment that I said, I would like to mention that, for example, here in Valencia we have the city of science, and they have built an opera, and if you want to buy a ticket, it costs about 200 euros. Sorry, 200 euros. And
oh,
I would like
gosh.
To say that, yes, it is focused on the upper class. And also I would like to say that the government is destroying the middle class, creating the middle.
Middle,
thank you. The middle class. And they are creating more difference between people, rich and poor people.
Yeah, the gap between the rich and poor is widening.
And
I'm very sorry about my technical problems. I really have been working on trying to improve the performance of my computer. Thank you so much. Congratulations on your English. That was super interesting. I thought all of you had incredibly valuable comments. So all the best. I just, you know, I miss living in Canada because we have such good social benefits, etc. But I really respect what a lot of other countries are doing with only a portion of the resources that countries like Canada have. So congratulations to all of you. All the best. I'll talk to you soon.
All the best. See you. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much for the class. Bye-bye.